Hey everybody, it's Rob Jolliffe. It's time for another Ask the Expert from Sabre Limited. We're going to take a look at Supply Chain 101 for manufacturing. Let's get into it. Okay, so Supply Chain 101 for manufacturing is one of my favorite topics. We're going to talk about it particularly in regards to all the documentation and the ERP processes that need to run through supply chain. So I'm Rob Jolliffe. I'm an expert in Microsoft Dynamics Business Central for manufacturing and supply chain. I have a background in manufacturing engineering. I have a background in supply chain, and I have a bit of a background in IT and programming as well. So I kind of bring them all together. I'm not great at any of them, but I understand them all. A couple of assumptions. If you're watching this video, you're probably a manufacturing company. You're probably in the small to mid-size area, size of manufacturing companies. So you have between 20 and 500 employees, but you're not some huge corporation with locations all over the world and tens of thousands of employees. If you want to talk to me, we put my calendar link in the description, and you can book a meeting with me. This is no pressure, no obligation. Just ask me any kind of question about any of my videos. I love to talk to the people who watch my videos and get their feedback and answer their questions. So we're going to jump into what is supply chain for manufacturing and how does that supply chain work in manufacturing? And we're going to use a diagram that I use quite frequently to kind of explain that. We're going to start with a customer, you, and your supplier. And we're going to talk about the interactions between these and how basically inventory and documentation move between these companies. So we start with your customer, and at some point in time, they want to buy something from someone. They may have bought from you in the past, but they want you to revise your estimates and quotes and confirm that they're accurate. They may never have bought from you, but they're going to send you something called a request for quotation, an RFQ. So the customer sends you an RFQ. From their point of view, it's a purchasing process. From your point of view, it's a sales process. What you're going to do is you're going to create an estimate. Now, I distinguish between estimates and quotes because an estimate is what's going to cost you to make something. And a quote is what you're going to sell it for. So you're always going to sell it for more than it costs you to make something, because otherwise you're just a charity. And the idea of the estimate is this gives you the baseline of what your costs are. The quote is the price you're showing to the customer. You don't show them your work. You just show them the end result. So your customer takes a look at it and they enter that into their system somewhere. Let's call it a purchase quote for the sake of argument. It's the analog to quote. It's the opposite of the quote. And they're going to make a decision. And I make little cloud icons to indicate things that are complicated, process-driven, they're bigger than just a simple document. So they sit down and they look at your quote and they look at other people's quotes and they make the decision about who they're going to buy from. And this would end really soon and be kind of a useless exercise if they didn't buy from you. So let's assume that they do go forward and they purchase from you. They're going to create a purchase order and they're going to send that purchase order to you. And this is the document that basically defines what they want to buy and that they've agreed to your quote. You're going to enter that into your system as something called a sales order. There are other ways of taking purchase orders and putting them in your system. But what you need to do is you need to have a list of all the customer's purchase orders that they've provided you in some central location where you can match that their purchase orders match yours. In accounting terms, it would be like an accounts payable reconciliation. In supply chain terms, it's really like that you've acknowledged and you have a place where you are documenting everything your customer is purchasing, because you don't want to miss something. If you miss something, if you don't ship what they expected, you're in trouble. All right, you're going to check your inventory. Do I have inventory for what I need on the sales order? Because the sales order, I need to ship it. I need to draw inventory to ship it. Now, the reality is in manufacturing companies, you often don't have that inventory. So instead of drawing the inventory, what you've done is you created like a virtual need. I'll call that demand. So there's demand against your inventory now, but you don't have it. So you're going to check and see, where can I get this from? Because I can't ship it until I actually have the inventory. So I'm not going to be able to ship it yet. What I'm instead going to do is check through, where can I get this? You might have another warehouse. And a lot of manufacturing companies maintain multiple manufacturing facilities. So that other manufacturing facility has a warehouse. Check their warehouse. If they have it, you transfer it. You use something called a warehouse transfer. And that has an in and an out. It has a inventory out of the other warehouse and an inventory into your warehouse. It's kind of like an internal sales order, purchase order process where you're moving stuff back and forth. Sometimes the other warehouse is a production facility and you have the raw materials. So you ship the raw materials from you to them so that they can produce the part and then ship it back to you. I'm not going to get into all the processes of the production order on their side because it's basically what I'm about to show you on the production order on your side. So let's say you don't have another warehouse and you can't do this. What you're going to probably do in most manufacturing companies is you're going to create something called a production order. Could be called a manufacturing order, could be called a job. There's different words used for it. In Business Central, the traditional module is the production order. The production order consumes components, which are drawn from inventory, and outputs materials, finished goods that are put into inventory. Now, sometimes this is even more complicated because the production order doesn't produce the thing you sell the customer. The production order produces something that's used by another production order to make the thing you sell the customer. So that's called a subcomponent. We'll, you know, assume that that isn't happening in this case. So I'm going to try and draw all the components I need for my production order from inventory. But let's say I don't have enough. Let's say, again, I have demand, but I don't have enough inventory. What I do is I create an RFQ. And now we're going to start noticing sort of a mirror image start to happen. So I create an RFQ, which I send to my vendor who creates an estimate and sends me a quote back. And then I take that and I track it somewhere in the system so that I know that they've sent me this quote. And ultimately, I compare all the quotes from all the vendors I asked to quote on this. And one of them gives me the best quote, which might not be the best price, but there's something about it I want to place a purchase order with them. So I cut a purchase order and then I send it to them. But that's created supply, not actual material, but the phantom material, the expectation of material in my ERP system. MRP is the process that kind of balances this out. When I have the sales order and I have the demand, the dotted line demand, not the real actual shipment, but just the need for it, that causes me to run this process, which will look at what I have on inventory and what I need. And that will cause me to create a purchase order ultimately, which then satisfies that. So it all balances after I have it right. Well, eventually they are going to take your purchase order, enter it in their system as a sales order, which they're then going to ship to you, which you're going to process as a receiver. And then you're going to get the hard inventory, the solid line. The solid line is the hard inventory that's just arrived. Now I've got the solid line inventory. So my components are now able to flow into my components, which allows me to run my production order and output the product to inventory. Now I have the product in inventory. And what am I going to do with it? Well, I'm going to take it out of inventory and I'm going to ship it to my customer. So my sales order becomes a shipment. The shipment goes to the customer and the shipment creates an accounts receivable invoice, which also is sent to the customer. So now the customer is going to do the same thing. They're going to create a receiver and they're going to have this AP invoice in their system. The AP invoice is going to be three-way matched between the receiver and the shipment and the purchase order. Like, does this all match together? Does it make sense? And if it does, they're going to send you a check eventually. Manufacturing company could be 2 years later, but, you know, I'm joking. It shouldn't be that long. But you're going to get a payment. You're going to deposit it in your bank. And exactly the same process is going to happen in mirror image between you and your vendor. And what you should notice now is I've used colors to try and highlight this. The dark blue are standard ERP functionality. And you'll notice that they mirror what the customer does to buy from you is a mirror image of what you do to buy from your supplier. And what the supplier does within to handle your order is a mirror image of what you do to handle your customer's order. Now, at some point in time, the supplier is making the same decisions you are internally. And those are the light blue things. And the light blue parts are the things your customer and your supplier don't need to know about. Probably your supplier might know more. Your customer probably knows you're a manufacturing company, but they don't have to know how you do it. They don't have to know where you buy it from. And that's the light blue. And within a manufacturing organization, that light blue is really important. If you were a distribution company, you wouldn't have the production orders. You would go basically from purchase order to shipment through inventory. And the production order process is actually really complicated. Compared to everything else that I've talked about, that would have its own flowchart that's at least as complicated as this one. So looking at it from a holistic point of view, you have yourself and you have that process we just talked about. You have your customer, you have your supplier, And then your customer has your customer's customer, and your supplier has your supplier's supplier. And this is why it's called a chain. It even looks like a chain when you put it on screen like this. So the supply chain is this repeating process of all of these flows of documentation that go back and forth through the entire path. So it's the chain of connections. What is the supply chain? It's a chain of connections between businesses. And inside those businesses, what you do varies. Like, you don't know how each business is producing or buying or sourcing the parts. Sometimes they reveal it, sometimes they don't. It's the secret sauce. And between any two companies, those points of interface should match. They should basically align with the supply chain process. And it's very standard. It's very industry driven, because you can't decide one day, I don't want to use purchase orders, I'm going to create my own thing. I'm going to create, you know, smoke signals, and I'm going to send that they won't accept it. There's this sort of an industry standard approach that's used. And that's a lot of what drives ERP. ERP is built around that industry-driven support process that every other company has decided to use. And it's all about moving products around. It's all about getting inventory to move between businesses. I'll make one little extra talk about this, which is that all these documents that are in all these ERP systems, they're also very much driven by the largest customers who are buying product, who want to use things like EDI, and that drives a lot of the reasoning why you use these documents. So as always, check out the links in the description below where we have additional information and resources, and there's other videos and articles related to this video as well, so please check those out. And subscribe to our channel, please. Follow. We have new videos weekly. And make sure that you not just click subscribe to our channel, but follow, which is the bell icon. And please like the video. It helps us get the word out there and helps people find our videos. Thanks so much. If you want to get in touch with us, here's our contact information. I look forward to hearing from you soon. Have a great day.